Hi everyone, Bud the Tool Guy here at ARES Garage and Workshop. Today we're going to talk about the 70370 valve spring compressing tool. This guy right here is what you need when you've got overhead cams and recessed valve springs. You can't get in there without something like this. So we're going to show you how to set it up and use it and some of the tricks that come along with it to make it work well for you. So here we go. Okay, on this tool, a lot of your time goes into setup and adjustments. If you don't put the time on setup and adjustments, it's not going to go well for you. You're going to fight it all the way through. So remember, also wear safety glasses with this thing, because you got the keepers and the springs and the caps, everything can come flying out, whatever, so protect your vision. So what I like to do on this is to set it midpoint on each one of these after I have chosen which one of these adapters here fit the caps on my valve springs the best. You want to come to the closest of the size of that cap as possible. So once you do that, then you're ready to start adjusting and keeping the throw of this in a manageable area to keep your leverage right, so you're not fighting that also. So we're going to go ahead and set this thing up and start the process. That way you can see how it's done. And also, we'll do a couple of the methods with the valve keepers. There's a lot of different things you can do out there. So, you know, you just kind of learn by doing on some of that stuff, what works best for you as far as dealing with the valve keepers and things like that. There's a lot of different methods. It's just gonna, like I say, whatever works best for you. So let's give it a go. Okay, so now this is a better view down inside the head. You can see that the valve springs are way down in here. And that's why you have to use a tool like we're gonna use to get at those things. And this is a high RPM head, and it has double valve springs in there. So without having a tool like that to compress those springs, there's no way you're gonna get this thing apart. So we're gonna give that a go, and you can see what happens. And here's a view. I'll tilt this up a little further. You can see what it looks like without the springs in there on those two valves. So they're in there deep. So we're gonna go after them. Here we go. Okay, we've kind of touched on it a little bit. Every once in a while, you'll run into a situation where these valve caps and the keepers are stuck together, and it makes it really hard compressing the springs and getting it all apart. So to help you out on that, you can take a piece of dowel, put it on top of the valve, give it a wrap. Don't be afraid to wrap it a couple of times. The other thing you can do is take a socket close to the size of the valve cap, put it on there. Same thing. Like I said, don't be afraid to wrap it a couple of times. You'll figure it out as you go on how much it's going to need. A word of caution, make sure that underneath here, the valves won't come in contact with anything when you're doing this. Some of the valves are very delicate. They're very small, with small valve stems. Some of them are sodium-filled hollow stems. They will bend if they come in contact with something underneath when you hit them. And obviously that's not very good. So always be sure the area underneath your valves are clear. Okay, so one of the things I like to do first is to get my foot adjustment set up. And I said I usually go midpoint. And then what I like to do is close the handle down on the tool and screw the cap compressing end down so it just comes in contact with the cap in order to hold this in position. And what I'm looking for is to make sure that I'm square on the face of the valve that I'm going to compress. That's extremely important. You want the tool in line following that valve. So, and they don't go straight up and down in the head. They're always at an angle, so you've got to set up for that. So that's why this is important. Some people just put the tool down in there and they go for it. I don't like doing that because there again, some of the valves are more delicate than others. You can catch an edge where you don't want to. So this is the better way to set up so you know you're on it the way you should be and that you're getting square on the valve. And so now we'll get things flipped around here for you and show you how we're set on the other end and begin compressing. Okay, so as you can see, we have the compressing end of the tool centered up on the valve spring as best as possible. You want to make sure that the window area of this cap end is open so that you can get at the valve keepers. I've just got enough tension on there right now basically to hold it in position so I can show you. Now we'll go ahead and do the adjusting to make sure we get enough compression to get the keepers free, and we'll get at those keepers with a magnet. Okay, so we've gone over the placement of the foot and the compressing end of the tool. So I just kind of want to go over a few things with this. One thing you can do is put some lubrication on your pivot points. That helps you with your leverage. The other thing is to keep this in a working area that's comfortable. Otherwise, if you get too far up here, you're going to fight it, and it's just no fun. So you want to keep it in a working area. So you just get enough compression to clear those keepers to get them out of there. So, and the proper choice of your adapters, very critical to keep stability. As close as you can get to the size of the valve cap is really important. So you just unscrew them off the ends here, and you can trade them out whichever way works. Midpoint adjustments to start with. So, we'll get there. Just lightly put it down, get a feel, make sure you are square on the face of that. And right now, I've got just enough tension on it that it's kind of holding it in place for me. And I can see that I'm gonna be fine as far as where, and you see I'm moving the tool a little bit, and walking around to make sure I can get in the window there to get at the valve keepers. I'm square on the face of the valve. Now, if I'm not compressed down enough at this point, the easy way to do this is to take it up with the foot adjustment, and you can press it down further this way until they clear. You can also do it here if you're not getting enough and get it down just so they clear. And now you can get the keepers out of there and go for it. It's really critical to get these adjustments right to get the stability of the tool, because some of the valves stick way up above, some are recessed like this, so you have to help yourself out or you're gonna fight it all the way through. Once you get your adjustments down, it works pretty simple and straightforward. Practice makes perfect with this, and that's really what it is. And by the time you've done your first hit,
okay, so now I've adjusted the tool to get a little more compression on the spring. So now I'll line it up there, make sure that the foot is getting where it's supposed to go. It is. Get this around so that I can get at those keepers and compress. So you can move this tool around a little bit to help break those guys loose, and if you need to get like a little screwdriver in here or whatever, you can help break them loose. And then you can get in here with a magnet and start pulling them out one by one. Let's see if we can get that other one out of there. Get the screwdriver in there and get it walked around a little bit. This is the fun part. There we go. And now we got them out. So then go ahead and relieve the pressure. And as you can see, the head kind of shifted around. You might want to secure it down to the bench some way, or have somebody hold it. They do make head stands. If you do this enough, it makes sense to have them, and that'll help keep things from moving around on you. So there, that's the cap, and you see this one has got a nice stepped, holds the spring in place. Your outer spring, your inner spring, and that's what I was talking about with the double springs. And now your valve is loose. You can push it out of there. It doesn't just fall out because the valve seal helps hold it in position. And then you can pull it out, and then you can service it as necessary. And so our next step will be reassembly. Okay, so now on reassembly, you lubricate your valve stem, which is really important because you've got a new seal in there, and you want your valve guide lubricated. So when you start up, you're ready to go. So now we put the springs in. Now on the cap, I loaded it with axle grease or bearing grease, and I stuck the keepers in there, and hopefully the grease will keep them somewhat in place, and then you put some grease on your valve stem. So this is one way to do it. Another way is just to put your cap in there, compress it, grease everything up, and then take tweezers or a screwdriver or something and get your retainers down inside there. And no matter which way you do it, it's always a bit of a challenge. And so you just have to work with it and see what works best for you. So then you get on there like you did on the disassembly. Make sure that your opening is going to be where you can get at the keepers to help line them up. Make sure you're on your face of your valve square. I was just watching to make sure that everything was staying pretty good. One dropped right into position. The other one still a little high. And you really do want to make sure that these guys get down where they're supposed to go. There's a groove on that valve stem that the ridge of the keeper locks onto to hold that cap in place. And as you can see, they're both now on that groove and will release the pressure. And there you go. You're reassembled. And you just repeat the process for every one of your valves. Oh, what fun it is. And you're set to go. And that tool is really what you need to do this. Like I say, just have some patience. Setup is everything. And have fun. Okay, so that's how it works. And that's why you need a tool just like this one to do it. This guy works really good for that stuff. Thank you for watching. Be sure to register your tool. Be safe out there. And we'll see you next time.